tell you the truth, I don't think this is a brain scan of operation.
Give me the camera. Give it off, down.
Good day, everyone. I'm Alex Navarro, and welcome to another bullet-riddled and spoilerific edition of Defending Your Movie. This is the feature where we, the editors of Screen, champion the flicks we believe in, despite society at large telling us, well, we shouldn't. If you ever had a secret shame movie you just couldn't bear to profess your love for publicly, this, my friends, is the feature for you. Today's movie is a little gem from way back in the year 2000, called The Way of the Gun. Now, you may remember this one as the directorial debut of Christopher McQuarrie, the man who wrote the award-winning screenplay for The Usual Suspects. Now, McQuarrie in the years following Usual Suspects' rise to cult classic status found himself having a lot of trouble getting actual work beyond just doing basic script doctoring stuff. Now, this is largely because he didn't really want to write another crime movie and just be sort of typecast as a guy who just does that. That said, eventually unemployment became kind of a thing, and McQuarrie decided to write Way of the Gun with sort of a fuck-all approach. The movie's kind of a southwestern crime movie in the darkest, most violent, and depraved tradition of Sam Peckinpah. McQuarrie even said he went so far as to write out a variety of scenarios he knew no standard movie executive would ever go for, and then find a way to fit them all into the screenplay. The end result was a gripping, hysterical, hyper-violent crime drama that I frankly loved the living hell out of. Sadly, I was in scarce company. Critics decried the movie's perhaps somewhat glorified and pointless violence, and hated the fact that for all its nifty dialogue and gritty style, there really isn't much of a story here beyond the scope of a bunch of lousy people doing a lot of lousy things to each other for like 2 hours straight. Audiences didn't exactly connect with it either, as despite it only having a $20 million budget, it was well in the red when it left theaters. Now this is a bit of a tragedy to me because while it's not the sort of movie mainstream audiences were ever really destined to pick up on, this is sincerely one of the most entertaining pure crime flicks I've seen in, like, the last 10 years. In fact, I think one of my favorite aspects of Way of the Gun is the fact that, as I said before, no one in this movie is particularly redeemable in any way, shape, or form. Take the two protagonists, Parker and Longbow. These guys, well, you know what, let's just watch the opening scene from the movie. This pretty much sums their characters right up.
Listen to me! Get off the fucking car with your fucking ass!
Shut that cunt's mouth or I'll come over there and fuck start her head!
Do something. Come. You're gonna wish you never fucking got up this morning, asshole, because my boyfriend's gonna fuck you up. And then after that, while he's fucking up your fucking gay uncle over there, I'm gonna fucking cut off your cock and mail it to your mother, you fucking faggot bitch. Gaylord fucking bitch. How do you like that? You like that a lot? You fucking faggot? You like to ass fuck? Fontanella fucking baby head fuck? You like to fuck baby heads? You like to fuck boys? He's gonna fuck you in the ass! How do you like that? He's not even gay, but he'll do it just
honey,
to fuck.
Honey, she's got a big mouth, but she's not kidding. I'm gonna whip you silly, and I'm gonna fuck you stupid. You wanna do the man dance? First dance is yours.
Right, so they're dirtbags. They're petty criminals who happen to find themselves with a potentially big score when they hear about a woman who is acting as a surrogate mother for a wealthy connected couple. They aim to kidnap the girl, and of course, things go horribly awry once they do. A variety of super intense, intricately staged gun battles give way to tons of crazy double crosses and a climactic battle intercutting one of the most brutal birthing scenes I've ever seen put to film. And a ton of dudes dressed like my grandfather running around a Mexican whorehouse, pumping absurd amounts of bullets into everything. It's an incredibly violent film to be sure, but the violence in this movie is so well staged and edited that it's kind of hard not to take some sort of perverse pleasure in it. Unless you're the seriously squeamish type.
I don't know.
There's also a shocking amount of completely decent acting in this movie. Ryan Phillippe, for instance, despite his weird, unplaceable accent,
are nomadic if not predatory miscreants who have some implied need to move around,
does a pretty good job of making you forget all that teen movie bullshit he did in the 90s. And Juliette Lewis, who can either be pretty good or insufferably annoying, depending on the movie, is actually totally pretty good here. Even Nikki Catt and Taye Diggs, of all people, do a great job as the emotionally detached bodyguards to Lewis's character. Especially Diggs, who I, frankly, have never seen more sociopathic than he is here.
Are you comfortable, Robin? We're going to take out your baby now.
The real stars of the show, though, are Benicio del Toro as Longbow, and also James Caan as Sarno, an aging bagman for the wealthy couple that has a vested interest in the situation. He is remarkably good here as a man who seems equally capable of carrying on a pleasant conversation with you and also murdering you in your sleep. The one scene these two share is one of my absolute favorite of the film. You should just take a second and watch these two work.
You got these trigger-happy cocksuckers all about the shooting and the posturing. You don't know who I am kind of thing. I've been to prison.
But you got caught, you dumb fuck.
Right? It's like these days they want to be criminals more than they want to commit crime.
Well, that's not just crime. That's the way of the world.
Now, see, the dialogue there is absolutely perfect. And in fact, Way of the Gun, much as was the case with Usual Suspects, is littered with nifty one-liners and elaborate stories that evoke the style of David Mamet without ever really feeling like a total ripoff.
One's backfire. Three is gunplay.
$15 million is not money.
Step up.
It's a motive with a universal adapter on it.
What do you think?
I think a plan is just a list of things that don't happen.
Karma's only justice without the satisfaction. I don't believe in justice.
Some of the stuff gets pretty deep into the merits of crime and violence as a profession, and frankly, some of it is just kind of downright hilarious.
Can't you people see there are guns here?
Above all else, Way of the Gun is just a movie with tons of style to spare. The visuals frequently invoke the sun-scorched style of Peckinpah, and the castanet and drum-heavy soundtrack creates an excellent oral atmosphere to the blood and guns nature of the thing. Apart from a few moments where things kind of drag a little bit, and usually scenes involving Juliette Lewis,
I'm pregnant.
I have a hard time finding a ton of fault with Way of the Gun. Granted, I'm a diehard fan of the works of Peckinpah, and McQuarrie's movie feels like a loving tribute to that unique style of crime picture. If you like your crime flicks gritty, unflinchingly violent, and full of clever words, you should definitely check out The Way of the Gun. And that's going to do it for yet another episode of Defending Your Movie. As always, feel free to hit up the comments to talk about some of your own defensible movies, as well as your thoughts on Way of the Gun in particular. As always, I'm Alex Navarro.
Until that day.